There's things that thump, things that bite, things that go bump in the night. What are these things? You sit and ponder, brace yourselves. It's called furry, furry, furry.
Finally. I was so tired of being a flower. Kara? Are you there? It's me. Your best friend.
Now hold on to the dreams you created for a happy life. It's alright. All the things we sought for so long will all be worth this fight. I will not destroy this world. I control time. Kara, you'll be mine. Your progress, your memories will be reset. We'll do it all over, Kara, you won't forget. Best part, I know you'll do it. Then you'll lose to me again. Lose again, over and over. That's what you'll do for your best friend. Cause you want a happy ending. You love your friends, who could blame you? You're filled with determination, Kara.
That is not my name.
We'll be here fighting together, playing for eternity. The strength that let you get this far, it's nothing compared to me. I feel your determination, I feel their hopes and dreams. They give me the strength to be here fighting for eternity. I've messed around with you for far too long. Let's purchase time again. Come with me, Kara, come with your best friend.
That is not my name.
Stop trying to live, stop all the dodging. Stop standing in my way. Please let me win for once in your life.
Kara is not my name.
You think you are something special. You're just a kid playing pretend. Don't get cocky, little Kara. Soon enough you'll meet your end.
You think you are something special. You're just a kid playing pretend. Don't get cocky, now as real. Soon enough you'll meet.
Walked a lonesome trail. Peace and love will sure prevail.
Help me end this sorry tale.
Deep inside I feel a fire burns within me ever higher. Knowing I will soon prevail, knowing I can end this tale. In a dream there is a chance. We grabbed at it at our first glance. My voice is song, we make the dance. It's been like this forever. Following our hopes and dreams when nothing is
ready to get whooped in Smash Bros?
As much as I'd love to lose repeatedly, I'm gonna practice magic.
You thought he already knew magic.
I do. But I want to get better at it than this.
You think it's a very cute letter opener.
That's why I want to get better! It's supposed to be intimidating! Yeah!
This is thrilling! I am absolutely excited for the opportunity to teach magic to my son.
I mean, I kinda know how to use it, but it just doesn't happen the way I want it to, you know?
Magic is admittedly very finicky. It manifests best as a representation of our individual strength and weakness. For example...
Whoa!
Fire can represent relentless fury and destructive hot-bloodedness. However... It can also be a comforting warmth and a protective light. Both aspects tell part of who I am and what to improve.
I think I get it.
Most, if not all, magic is personalized in this manner.
So, by that logic, this is my self-esteem.
No.
I can't explain it any better than your mother did, son. Magic is an energy that reflects us.
So, what's your trident mean?
Tridents are weapons wielded by authority, like Poseidon or Shiva.
Or the devil.
That crossed with the whole fire thing is just charming, huh? Not my first choice, but magic tends to weaken if you force it into different forms.
Weird. So it's better to let it happen naturally?
Yup. Could explain why your blade needs work.
So I'll go for fire then.
Hey, don't worry about it. We all start small. I was a late bloomer too.
They would love camping by the lake. You just be sure not to let Frisk stuff themselves with s'mores. Hmm? Asriel? He is a tad stressed, but... otherwise in good health. I suspect it is because he has been frustrated with his use of magic. You think he's trying too hard.
I know. I keep trying to make what I want. But if fire isn't even my thing, what is?
Relax and let it happen. It is odd, because it does not seem to be an issue of power. He certainly is not weak. It almost feels like he has been holding back. As if he is afraid of what his power really amounts to.
Huh? No! 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 No, no, no! 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 Stop! Stop it! That's not who I am! It's not what I am! That's not what I am! That's not... it's not...
I do not think it is a serious situation. He is a bright young man. He'll grow into it.
And without any sort of costume. You feel somewhat cheated.
Now, why would I need to dress up as some out there creature when I'm already one, huh? Besides, October's the one month of the year where I'm comfortable being a weirdo. You gotta embrace that. Look at Sans, for example.
That skeleton is lit!
When push comes to shove, Scruff, you sure can make an entrance.
Show it to me!
Hey, Assy, we're pals and all, but I already denied the Bone Zone to like a million fangirls. I can't afford to make you an exception.
What? You know? Gosh, no! I mean, how you use your shortcuts. You know, when you bloop and you're gone. I want to learn that!
Oh, well, that's easy. You just gotta do this.
Do what? How the fuck? So this day celebrates generosity given. Just before the backstabbing and slaughter of this land's previous inhabitants? Is that right?
Firstly, that's cold. Secondly, if you humans are into celebrating sick crap like that, where's our holiday?
You don't know? You're honestly just here for the food. You ask Asriel if you come off as a weird kid.
You're a 9-year-old kid with a goldenrod complexion, adopted to a family consisting of centuries-old Capran creatures and what can be best described as a zombie. Your best friend is an armless raptor, and you're responsible for integrating an underground country into society as a political representative.
When worded that way, you sound pretty awesome.
I don't have time to question reality! Because the reality is, life is great, because I make it so. Right. Sans, how do you handle an existential crisis?
Usually I make a bad joke and laugh it off. My bro has a point though. Don't worry about if you matter in the world. Focus on what matters to you. You make the most of what you have, and you make your own place in the universe. But if it makes you feel better, to us, you're as real as it gets.
Well, thanks. I...
Alright, dudes. Firstly, do not try this at home. I am a pro, and I got a trained medic on standby.
Children, I have made you some lemonade. What are you doing?
I'ma break this board in half with my face!
Asriel, when I asked you to watch them, I hope you would keep them from being irresponsible.
And I did. I talked them out of trying to break the cinder block.
Tell me more of your adopted human sibling.
Well... Kara and I were best friends. To be honest, though, I think I just said that because they were my only friend. For some reason.
I would keep a distance if I were you. He's got fleas.
Ew!
Lacking a playmate, huh? Why not Jerry? Is it true you got fleas? Can I see?
I want my mom!
Not like there were a lot of options. Kara and I were a pretty good duo, though. We'd get into all sorts of mischief together.
Oh, shoot! That was Mom's favorite vase! She's gonna obliterate us!
Do not panic. I am thinking. I have a plan. You write on the wall with Mother's lipstick and distract them, while I pick up the pieces and fix it.
They always had good escape plans. Sorta. Kinda sucked for me. Always getting in trouble. Taking the blame like I was... some... sort of...
scapegoat!
That's clever. And you didn't object to Kara's plans.
Coffee? Tea? Cocoa?
Cocoa, please. And I did, but I'd end up being called a crybaby. Didn't like that.
You had trouble standing up for yourself, even in wake of Kara's desire to wipe out a human village?
At the time, I didn't know. They worded it differently. I don't want to be nosy, but don't you get worried sometimes?
Worried of what?
Your family. You know, your human family.
You are my family. I do not need any humans. Humans do not know love, or compassion, or joy. They lost that when they created the barrier and banished your kind.
Yeah, I bet if we monsters could reach the surface, we could teach them. Maybe finally make peace.
I have a plan.
Apparently, buttercups are a bad way to go.
Okay, remember the plan. As soon as I see it, take the soul. Pass the barrier. Pass the barrier. Change the world.
So far, so good.
Sweet cheese sticks, what is that orb of pain?
Calm down. It is the sun.
Okay. So how does the rest of the plan go?
We will go to my village. There, we shall place my body by the golden flowers. Show the humans the godlike power we can achieve when monsters and man unite in peace and harmony. And kill them all!
I'm sorry, what? Why did you say all like that? We only need 6 souls!
That is true. However...
What?
I have a very high respect for monsters.
Okay, but...
And humans, they are violent and ruthless.
How?
Kara!
Why not give a demonstration of our power?
How would that help?
By attracting attention. And making a statement.
I don't know what you're doing with the body of a child, but you best back away before anyone else gets hurt.
This is exactly what I was saying. Always quick to attack.
I can sense your intentions, Kara. Don't fight him.
We must show them what a monster can really do, my brother.
You said we were going to show them love.
Love comes from respect, and respect comes from fear.
No.
And we will show them
no.
why we should be feared.
No! Stop right there!
What are you doing?
I'm putting in my say.
Azrael, stop. Give me back control.
No. I call shotgun.
You cannot call shotgun on a body.
Well, I did.
Brother, this is not a game. If we do not act now, the humans could...
I can't think of a worse time to finally grow a pair.
You have been shot. Give me control so I may retaliate.
No!
Azrael, you are dying. You can level this town with a snap of your fingers, yet you are dying.
I won't fight.
They are a disease, Azrael!
Why is it still moving?
I can feel your hate, Kara. Your hate for them. It resonates from your soul. You shouldn't be near something you despise so much.
Don't let it get away! Jeez, why won't it go down?
You're going back to your real home. Where you are loved and cared for. To... rest. It's better here. Don't you... think? Kara?
You... You... You idiot.
Those last words refused to leave me.
How do you think that event affected you in later times?
I don't know. It might have messed me up a bit. Just a little, though. Being a soulless flower probably amplified it. I mean, I think that's the worst part! I can't blame it all on Kara. I was too freaking spineless to say it was a bad idea sooner. I helped them go through with it. They might have adopted that kill or be killed mentality, but I acted on it. The time loops, the betrayal, the destruction, heck, projecting that attitude onto someone who actually knows how to love, that's on me. That's on me.
I acted out of fear. That day at the village, when I first reset, now some cosmic stars align or whatever. It's given me another chance at life. Maybe to fix things. Be the prince of this world's future. Or just another opportunity to ruin everything. And that scares me. I don't deserve this.
Mr. Dreamer, while your situation is unique, your emotional state is actually very common. You've been linking your self-worth to the expectations of others. And in the event of not meeting such expectations, you consider yourself inadequate, or even weak or worthless. Because of this, you blame yourself for the events and traumas long ago. You are stronger than you allow yourself to believe. You overpowered a human soul to avoid conflict. You shattered the barrier and freed monster kind. You escaped death itself. And you came here for help. Those don't seem like weaknesses to me. Don't value yourself through faults, but strengths. If what you claim is true, you must have spent centuries reliving the past. You need to break free of that self-doubt holding you there. Trust in those who love you. They'll remind you of your worth and help you carry forward. That way, you'll never be weak, and you'll never be alone. Stay determined.